I am Dr. Anto Richard. I work as assistant professor in Theresian College, Mysore. I stay with my family, my parents, and my two brothers, and I've got a wonderful, beautiful wife. Today I want to share with you how this word of God became true in my life. Trust in the Lord with all your heart. Lean not on your own understanding. In every step, consult him, and he will make the path straight. Up in Mysore, that is Karnataka. I have been to this divine since my youth days. In every year I come here, God has really blessed my education. He has taken my education to heights. I completed my PhD. In 2013 I came to this retreat with two intentions. One was thanksgiving for my PhD submission. Second was intention of constructing house. By 2014 May, my house got constructed and I got the award PhD degree. The second was the marriage. The marriage was fixed. I got married in 2014, 18th May. I told my wife God's blessing. We said let us go to Divine and let us thank God for this wonderful marriage. My beautiful wife, Miss Lydia Vandana, said, okay, we'll go. We both came 24th May 2014 as a Thanksgiving retreat. As a young couples, we had a lot of dreams and joy. We came and this was honeymoon for us. We came, praised God, thanked God. For 1 week, we went to Mysore back with full of dreams. 2014, in the month of August, we discovered that we can't have a child. It was sad. It was something you can't express that through words. We had suffered a lot because we could see our friends getting children. My friends already got two children, they became dad. Even I wanted to become parents, myself and my wife. But the fact was, we cannot. Every month, we expected, it was disappointing. It was something very burden on a family, myself and my wife. People asked, any good news? We were not able to tell them. 6 months passed, they asked, any good news? We said, no. 1 year passed, they started asking, they started speculating, there is some problem, but we were not able to tell them because of problem, because I felt it was a shame to tell. I used to cry, my wife used to cry. Every day we used to pray on our bed, asking God, please help us. Have I committed any mistake? This was a doubt in my mind. But the strength was the retreat which I made in DRC. All that word was strengthening me. Come on, Anto, don't give up faith. Doctor said, you can go for IUI and IVF. I asked doctor, what is the problem? Why this has come to me? They said, Anto, it's bad luck. The last chance you can try is you can go for IVF. I knew it was against Catholic Church. The spirit was in me very strong, telling Anto, don't go for that. Again, myself and my wife decided, we'll come to this Divine Retreat Center. We had all exams duty. We finished all our college work. We came in the month of May 5th, 2017 with this great burden. Every day, every session was directed to us. Every talk was for us. God is telling, don't worry, don't worry. I have a plan for you. Then counseling came. We were desperate to meet Father Jacob Arimpur for a counseling. In his busy schedule, somehow we could arrange for a counseling. We narrated all our problems. Even I said, Father, I have made a wrong choice. Oh, Father, people say it's a curse. Those who don't have children, is it a curse? He prayed and said, there is no curse. I can't see any curse on your family. When Jesus has died for us, there is no curse for a believer. That was a signal, clear word for us. He prayed for us and he said, all the best. If God has brought you together in marriage, God has a plan for you. Stick on to it. Be faithful. He prayed for us. And the last talk was about Holy Spirit. The preacher father said, pray to Holy Spirit every day. Pray to Holy Spirit. Then We went with great hope and trust in God. We went back to Mysore. We started praying every day to Holy Spirit. We were faithful to sacrament of Eucharist and confession. In the month of August, God gave us a surprise. I was little reluctant to go for this test. My wife, trusting God, went for a test, and it was good news that my wife conceived. Praise God. Nothing is impossible to Jesus. Everything is possible to Jesus. Then, April 4th, my wife delivered a girl baby to me. It was a princess. I'm very happy that Jesus really made a miracle in our family. Dear brothers and sisters, we have heard about miracles, but I have seen miracle in my family. Praise God. Praise Jesus. Praise Holy Spirit.
Brothers and sisters in Christ, my name is Astra Fernandez. I hail from Bombay, married with a husband, Blaise Fernandez, two children, a son, Conrad Fernandez, and a daughter, Julie Fernandez. I am here today to witness God's tremendous love and the way He has sustained my family and my husband and my kids over the last 20 plus years. The last time I visited the Divine Retreat Center was with my husband way back in May of 1997. You see, that was the year we as a young family were migrating from Abu Dhabi to Canada. We passed by India in Bombay to take a 3-month break so that we could introduce our children to their original country. It was during this time, within the first week itself, that my husband Blaise collapsed and was admitted to the Raheja's hospital in Bombay. Being there for a whole week, he came out only with insulin because his sugar levels were very high. Sitting at his bedside at the hospital, we were at ends. We did not know what to do. So Bible in hand, we prayed and we changed our plans. Instead of touring India, we kept our children with my sisters and decided to visit the Divine Retreat Center. So as you see, we came into these doors very confused, very rejected, dejected, not knowing how much the future had for us, specifically when all that we had worked for was on the verge of crumbling. The Divine Retreat Center itself was difficult during those days. It was the beginning, and accommodation was difficult. Place found it very hard, but he endured. We went through the services expecting great things. However, during the infilling of the Holy Spirit, we both had a tremendous spiritual experience. Funny, it was nothing physical. There was nothing physical to show for it. But inside, we were just filled with the Holy Spirit. God's love overcame us. And the words came to mind, "Be not afraid, for I am with you even to the end of time." Another set of words kept coming to mind that says, "If God is with you, who can be against you?" And that was so consoling because we were going to a new country where we knew no one. We were starting at root level all over again, and that too on a very bad wicket. But God was telling us, "If I am with you, nobody can be against you." And then he also went on to say, "I have carved you on the palm of your hand, of his hand." Literally, living on these promises of God, we took the very bold step of continuing our journey and going into Canada. Canada was no piece of cake. We had to deal with a lot of things. Among that was Blaze's deteriorating health. His health deteriorated so badly that he had to give up work, and our struggles were compounded with looking after 2 children and a sick husband. All this time, we only had God to rely on. I used to say, I do my crying in the rain. But what I really meant was the cry of my heart was heard by God and no one else. When no one was with us, He sustained us in the palm of His hand. He carried us through our trials. Lo and behold, Blaze became very sick. He had cancer in 2005, had to stop working, led him to a triple bypass operation, which led him to neuropathy into his entire body, led him to his kidneys failing, led him to dialysis. So you can only tell from the journey we've been through that it was no easy walk. But God always assured us. In our journey, we never doubted Him. We never asked Him why. We just trusted that all would be good because God was with us. You never found us crying. In fact, we were an inspiration to our friends. We never cried. My husband embraced his cross just as Christ embraced his and offered his suffering like Christ did for the people. And so we journeyed. Watching us journey through this life so exceptionally, our little son was now growing to be a man. And he pondered on a vocation of being a priest. Lo and behold, today I can say that God blessed us with a priest in our house. My son today, Father Avinash Conrad Fernandez, is a Franciscan priest of the Orders of Franciscan Minor. As life went on, Blaze survived from the years of 2005 to 2017, 8 near-death experiences. He knocked on death's door 8 times and literally was sent back to us. It was a laughing joke, doctors would say. Here is a dead man walking. My husband would say, I'm living on borrowed time. And today I know that God kept him alive to see all his ambitions. He saw his son ordained. He saw his daughter married. And I think it was too much to ask to see his grandchildren. So he had to go up to the Lord. On the 6th of June, the Lord called him home. But he was not sad to go, because throughout those years we were encouraged by the words of Scripture itself, where God tells us, Jesus says, in my Father's house there are many mansions, and I go there to prepare a room for you. I would not tell you this if it were not true. I will come back and take you to it myself, so that where I am, you may also be, and your joy would be fulfilled. These words of Scripture, we repeated in our house over and over again. We lived with faith. Death had lost its sting. We no longer feared death. In fact, we looked forward to it. My son would say, in the Franciscan, you know, mother, we call death brother death. So we would say, brother death, welcome in your time, and take us forward to live in our Father's house. That day happily came on the 6th of June 2007. Very peacefully, Blaze passed into his Father's house. What greater honor could he have? That he had, not only did he have his whole family beside him, but he had a priest beside him who led him to the last rites, who said all the prayers for the dying, who so nicely consoled me with his hands on my shoulders. What more could I ask for? God was with us 1,000%, if there is such a thing. Not only did he take place over, but he gave his family the sustenance and the joy in the faith that we have, that there is no death. It's merely a going over to our Father's house. We rejoice in death. Welcome it at any time. This, dear friends, is the 20 years plus that God's love has sustained us. 1997, 2017. I was never leave you often. All we really have to do is believe and trust. He never, ever will let you down. Praise God. Amen.
Hello, my name is Sheila Almquist. I live in Petaluma, California, north of San Francisco. I come from an Irish Catholic family. I have three brothers. I presently work for an organization called Council on Aging. It's a nonprofit organization, and I help seniors. I am a case manager, and I navigate seniors' lives for them. I am here to tell you how God has changed my life. At the age of 20, I was married very early in life, and I married a non-Christian, and we weren't married in the Catholic Church, which was really against my parents' wishes, but we were married in a park in Hawaii, and we tried for many years to have children. In fact, we tried for 20 years to have children, and I had much sadness in my heart. I went through a lot of infertility programs. I took a lot of infertility drugs, but for some reason, God didn't bless us with children. And I think it had a lot to do with the fact that I wasn't close to Christ. I went to church on a regular basis, but I didn't really have a relationship with Christ at that time. My husband wasn't interested in Jesus, so that really hardened my heart. I had a very hard time with that. So I was married from my 20s to my 40s and with much pain, and I've always longed to have children. I don't always long to be around children or teach children. I went to school to become a teacher, but ended up with older people. So I'm a charismatic Catholic. I belong to two charismatic prayer groups, Christ the People of King in Rohnert Park, California, and the Petaluma Charismatic Prayer Group in Petaluma, California. And there is a convention every year in Santa Clara, which is a couple of hours away from where I live. And I attend that convention. And there was a table set up. And there was an Indian table set up about a convention that was going on, a retreat that was going on in India. And I have a friend that comes to India every year, and she has been encouraging me to come to India for Ayurvedic treatment. But I went to this table and I asked them. She said, sure, we have retreats every week and that you should come. Well, India is a big state, and I booked my hospital stay, and I thought, while I'm in India, I should see about the Divine Center. Maybe it's close, I'm not sure. It ended up being only 3 hours away. So I spent 28 days at the Ayurvedic hospital, and then I drove here to the retreat center because it was only 3 hours away. Now that is God calling me, because India is such a large place, and I mean, for it only to be 3 hours away, I had to come. As soon as I drove into the complex, I started to cry, because it just seemed like heaven on earth. All the posters of Jesus, the banners of Jesus, everybody praying. I saw people praying with their rosaries. And then when the retreat started, the music that was playing, it seemed like it was angelic. It seemed like we were in heaven. The angels were singing from heaven. And then the priest that spoke, he spoke of really getting straight with God. He spoke of the Ten Commandments to begin with, and he went through them biblically. And then what I was really impressed with was that almost everything that he spoke about had a Bible scripture. He described the Bible the whole entire weekend. The whole weekend, he quoted Bible scriptures. And Hebrews 11:1 says, faith is confidence in the things hoped for and assurance of the things that we cannot see. And I hoped for a closer relationship with Jesus here. I'm starting another decade in my life, and I have a birthday coming up, and I'm just not happy with what I'm doing. I'm just not happy with my life. I know that there's more in life. And after coming here and being at the retreat and hearing the priest and hearing all the speakers, and they just invited me to trust in Jesus more and to look through the scripture and to go to confession and to have the Blessed Sacrament as often as I could. And also, it's important to spend time in adoration. And so what I'm leaving here with is to be sure to be in, to ask Jesus for help. Go to him and ask him. Jesus wants us to ask him for help. Then to go for reconciliation on a regular basis, every 2 weeks. I wasn't doing that. My last reconciliation was maybe 5 months ago. And then to go in front of the Blessed Sacrament, and then to have the Eucharist on a regular basis. I'm going to hope to go to church and have the Eucharist every day. That's what I'm going to shoot for. And then to go out and spread the word. So during the retreat, we had a number of different things that we did, and one of them was reconciliation with the priest. And the priest that I spoke with, I let him know that, you know, I had a longing in my heart for children, and I've had a little bit of a resentment to God. I wasn't sure why God didn't allow me to have children. And during that reconciliation, the words that he spoke to me really went deep into my heart. And he let me know that Jesus has a plan for me. And so my heart was let free. It was just let free after the reconciliation, and then after seeing that, and then we had adoration. And it was the most beautiful adoration. I go to adoration, but I never experienced an adoration quite like the adoration here at Divine. The music was beautiful, the words that they spoke. My heart has just been set free. So the one scripture reading that really has touched my heart and has helped set me free is, if God is for us, who can be against us?